There are a million ways to get frustrated when editing or shooting a video, and keeping track of everything in your editing project should not be one of them. Here is a way to keep your edit organized that I call the hit by the truck rule.
Ow.
Howdy, Jeff Bartsch here with Story Greenlight, where we are all about helping you use creative video editing and powerful storytelling so that you can connect with your audience, turn up the impact of your work, and change people's lives. That's what we're all about here. So if you're new to the channel, consider hitting that subscribe button and hit that bell so you don't miss a single video. Now, in my background editing television here in LA, there is a workflow that professionals use that I refer to as the hit by a truck rule. And what that is basically, if, God forbid, I were to get hit by a truck or a minivan.
Ow.
And someone had to step in to take over my editing work on whatever show I'm cutting. They could do that. And that's something that I would like to propose to you, because even though with online video, we mostly shoot and edit our own stuff, we don't have to hand it off. The fact that you could means that you have a workflow that means you don't get bogged down by the stupid stuff, by the little things that shouldn't be an issue. And it means that you can focus on the stuff that actually matters, which is telling your stories. When you want to shoot and your toddler insists on not napping. Here are three ways to put the hit by a truck rule into effect. Now, before we say what those are, let me just show you what we don't want. Say you're in a sample project in Premiere and you say, okay, let's bring in some footage. Let's take all that. Let's bring all that in. Okay, there's all my stuff. Gonna take all that stuff, put it into the sequence. Create a new sequence. Oh, and then you add a whole bunch more stuff. Let's bring in a whole bunch of sound effects. Ta-da, we got lots of stuff here. But we need music too, so let's bring in some music. We have all kinds of stuff, and to find anything, you have to hunt around, you have to scroll. It's madness. Stop the madness. Which is even worse if you want to go down here in this tiny little version of your project window and you say, I want to get that one music clip or that one video clip, and like, or where's my sequence? It's like, you can't find it. It's just bad. Now, for the record, if you do know exactly what you're looking for, Premiere has a great little search window where you can type in exactly what you want and it'll pop right up. I use this a lot for looking for effects like crop or the life-changing warp stabilizer. But the fact of the matter is, if you're looking for something like MVI.2808, it's like you don't know what the stuff is called. Or especially if you're looking for a music clip, like one cue that you don't know which one you want to use out of like a bunch of 30 of them, you really do need a way to find things quickly that doesn't rely on just the search window. Here's what you do instead. You go into your project window and you make a minimum of two separate folders. Call it cuts, and then call it elements. That is the most very basic version of organizing that you want, because you have two things that you're working with. You have sequences that you're doing the actual editing to, and then you have all the stuff that goes into those sequences. Here's a recent project that I worked in Premiere, and here's what you have. This is the piece where I was talking about. Let's talk about how to win one of these. Talk about going to stand in front of the Emmy statue and everything. So here is how the project is organized. It has one cut in the active cut bin, all the other stuff in the old cuts bin. Under elements, it has all the actual things that I shot. All that. Never actually used that clip, but whatever. Amazing lighting on that. Then you have some graphic elements that I brought in. I have common elements, the stuff that I want to have access to and everything that I do for the YouTube channel here. And then I have all my main stuff from Epidemic Sound. And then there are also folders for adjustment layers and nests, just because I don't want to have that stuff dangling out in the middle of everywhere. But the whole point is, if I needed to find one specific video clip, one specific music clip, I know exactly where to go. It's not buried in all this other stuff. Second way to apply the hit by the truck rule, always keep things clearly labeled. Going back to our sample project here, say we have our three main bins. I've imported some video clips. We are gonna just drop them into the sequence. And we have ourselves a blurred shot right there. And this guy. This is the actual sequence that you're working with, but it's labeled the same as one of the clips itself. For the love of all that's holy, do not leave it labeled like that. We need to take that sequence, put that in your current cut, and label it. Name what you're actually working on. Demo cut, edited January 1st, 2026, because we're living in the future here. Third way to use the hit by the truck rule. Always keep alternate versions of things. So say we have our sequence here. This is what's loaded up. And let's say that we've already done the editing that we've wanted to do. And we don't know whether we want it to be like version A or version B. What you must not ever do is throw away work that you've done. If you say it's like, well, I like this version right here. I'm gonna try an alternate version. You go and you duplicate that puppy and you say, and you label it, say cut, just for whatever, just here, just say, let's call it cut three. And then now that you have that cut, make sure that you're actually working in that cut. I'm just gonna change that and we'll just get rid of you. We're gonna change that and we're gonna pull you around and all that. And we're gonna say, okay, great. Perfect edit, we love it. And now you can go back and forth and you can compare between cut two and cut three and you never have to worry about throwing anything away or it's like, oh, well, I like the way we did it that other time. It's like, well, you will always have a version of that time saved if you duplicate sequences. By the way, if any of this is helpful, do me a favor and hit the thumbs up button. It really does help. And as a way of saying thank you, here's me getting run over again by a minivan.
Ow.